Welcome to this week's piece. So as you can see, I've had this guy for a while because it is right next to the mermaid dresser that I did. I had grand plans for this, and then it just kind of sat and I didn't do what I originally wanted to. But it's super cool. Secretaries are one of my most favorite things to work on. I love the size of them. They're small, but they have a ton of storage. It's cute. I love them. I don't know how many I've done so far, but it's been a lot. So this one is a great piece overall. It's nice mahogany. The drawers are a little tight on it, and it obviously has some big scuffs and scrapes and stuff, but overall it's in great condition. So to start, I'm just going to remove all the hardware and get things situated. The locks are a bit stiff, so I'm going to WD-40 these. I do that a lot of times before I clean because it leaves such a residue. Now you can do this after you've sealed and waxed and stuff, but I want to make sure I can go through all the locks, which I don't show because you guys have seen me do it several times, but I'm just going to use some WD-40 on all the locks and get all the mechanisms working. One of the things I absolutely love about these old secretaries is the stuff that you find inside. And it's usually not in the drawers, but it'll be either in the little hidey holes or back behind the mini set of drawers that go in the top. So I found this in there. I also find a lot of really old stamps, which I think is fun. Anyways, back to this. So I'm just cleaning out this intersection. What I'm going to do is strip back the drop down leaf portion of it because I want that to be brought back to wood. That's what I'm keeping. Everything else has a very thick lacquer on it. That does too. It has a thick lacquer on it, but there's a lot of scuffs and scrapes in it that I want to be able to sand out a bit. I won't be able to get them fully out because some of them are very, very deep, but for the most part, I want to get this brought back to wood. And then the rest of it, since I'm going to be painting, I want to leave the lacquer on because it's going to help stop bleed through. Now, I'm still going to have bleed through. This is mahogany. It's just the nature of the wood. But if you don't sand through all of it, it will help prevent some of the bleed through. Because this lacquer was so thick, I did have to go through several rounds of stripper, which is pretty typical for this type of finish. you can see here, I'm just using a sanding disc with my hand. If I had to guess, I'd say this is probably a 220. I do not want to go through the lacquer that is on this. I want to keep it intact as much as possible, but I do want to give a little grip to the surface for my paint to adhere to. So around the edges of the drawers, you'll see that I'll get bleed through there. And sometimes around the holes, because that'll come through from where the hardware was. So you'll notice a few spots, and you can go over the entire piece if you have a piece like this with shellac, and that will generally give you a really good sealer for bleed through. You can also use a stain blocking primer. For me, I have also found that mahogany tends to bleed through all of those things, and you kind of have to do multiple coats. So just keep that in mind. A lot of times I'll do this step with the wax at the end, but these drawers were so hard and so sticky that I had to do them at the beginning to make sure that I could get them to slide in and out easily without the hardware on them. I just took care to not get any of the wax on the fronts, and if I did, I got it cleaned off so that it didn't mess with any of my paint adhesion. And since I had it out anyways, I went ahead and just did all the inside of the drawer boxes as well. And now I can go through and just give everything a clean. I believe I mentioned this in my last video, but my cleaning solution for this in particular is just vinegar, water, and a bit of Dawn dish soap. Now, white is a terrible idea on mahogany just because of the bleed-through situation, but I'm just doing this here to give me a base for the papers that I'm going to decoupage onto it. I'm still going to see bleed-through here. I already know that it's going to happen, and you guys know if you've been watching me for a while, a lot of times I will just work with the bleed-through. So knowing that it's going to happen, kind of embracing it instead of blocking it out. If you don't want it, you can totally block it out and use one of the methods that works best for you. But I typically don't mind if I'm going to work it into the piece. So I'm painting these white. I haven't exactly decided where I'm going to put the decoupage paper, so I'm just going to do an entire base coat of the white. This is not the color that we're going to end with. This is just going to give me a good base for decoupage, and then also I will be able to see where the bleed through is going to come out to kind of help me with my final design. So to do my decoupage, I always use poly. In this case, I'm using the Helmsman spar urethane. This is just in the gloss. This is just what I had on hand. I'm usually not terribly picky. There's only a few situations where I have a particular need for a certain kind of poly for decoupage. You'll also notice once you poly over the paint that you'll start getting your bleed through more if you never put that blocker down. I'm doing these flowers here and I'm going to add color to them, so I'm not worried about that. You've seen me decoupage a billion times probably by now if you've been watching my channel for a while. But for this tissue paper, since it was on a rectangular sheet, I actually ripped out the design of the flower so that I had irregular edges instead of those sharp straight edges. It just helps it blend more easily into the final product. And then I add a base layer of the poly, and then I am just using the brush to lay that down. I'm getting rips and tears in this. I'm not worried about the rips and tears for this specific design because it's going to be a bit messy, and you can paint over any tears that you need to fix later. And there's just a lot of ways to fix this. These are curvy drawers, and it's just going to be a pain to try and worry about it getting so perfect. So I just don't worry about it being perfect. I worry about getting it on there and making sure that it's going to be something that will last and that I will be happy with in the end. So once I get them on, you can use a razor blade to cut out the drawers. You can use sandpaper then to kind of clean off the edges. I will wrap the edges while it's still wet. You can see it here. I'm pushing the edges of the paper down to make sure that they're wrapped and they have a good seal. And then I can clean them up later. Now, you can see the tears on the paper around the edges. Like I said, I'm not worried about that at all. It's going to be perfectly blended into the piece when I'm finished. So initially, I was going to do this piece a lot lighter. It was going to be in kind of swirly tones of grays and blues, how I do kind of my stormy blends. It was going to be of that nature. And then after seeing the flowers on here and everything, I was like, you know what? I think I'm going to go dark. And that's kind of what I did, which, if we're being honest, helps with the bleed through. I didn't have to work with a lot of it anyways because I ended up going so dark with it. But if you weren't going to go dark with it, you can use those colors in your final finish and it will work out perfectly. So I'm just doing black now. This is going to be my base. I'm going in, cleaning up all the edges where anything was torn or ripped or where you can see underneath and see any of the white. Just going around everywhere. I use my fingers a lot to blend things out and make it look a little more shaded like it is on the actual flower. So I just kind of go back and forth with the brush and with my finger and try and get things the way that I think that they will look good. And this isn't even the final step. This is just going to give me a base to add my color to later. You see me switch back and forth between brushes. In case it's not obvious, it's because the small brush is really easy to get into the details and get smaller areas, and the large brush just makes quick work of everything. So that's why I go back and forth between the two brushes. I just want to do a close-up here and a little slowdown because as I'm going around the edges of the paper, I'm meeting up with the print but going over the edges of the paper, and then I'm using these small strokes. I don't want a smooth finish on this secretary. I want it to be kind of brush strokes everywhere and a little bit of texture and everything because it will help the other colors when I add on later to have a place to go. But then also this will help blend the paper itself into the piece, so it won't look so out of place to have a really smooth finish and then a not so smooth finish where the paper is. So I'll just kind of work around. Again, I've got the small brush and I'm just doing small strokes, adding them in, and then I'll go in and make big swirls and everything with the rest of the finish to keep it all cohesive. Now I'm going in with my second coat of Blackboard. This is obviously because I had the white base underneath and I need to make sure that I'm covering all that. Had I not had to do a white base underneath and it would have just been the dark mahogany, I probably wouldn't have had to have done the second coat with the black, but in this case I did. And then for this part, I'm just filling in the second hardware hole. I had so much trouble. The original hardware that I had planned to use was from the little tall boy that I did, and I had mentioned that it has really bendy pulls that you can use on secretaries. It was completely sold out. There were none left. So then I ordered a set of French provincials that I hated on it. I didn't like, and when I went to bend them into, they snapped in half, so that made me really upset. And then I found another pair of bail pulls, or I should say another set of bail pulls, and they didn't work out either. So thankfully, I had another set of hardware on hand that were just individual holes, which kind of bummed me out because I didn't want to fill these. I actually wanted bell pulls on them initially, but it's fine. We do what we can with what we have. And thankfully, I had just the little single hole pulls on hand. Again, I just used Durham's putty for this, filled them up, had tape on the back, and then I'm just going to go in with the black paint and hide up the holes. And you'll barely be able to see them at all once it's finished. Now, had I known that I was going to use single hole hardware, I obviously would have done this step at the beginning. Now, my favorite part of secretaries is also my least favorite part to actually work on. So these are just kind of a pain. I think it's best to spray them if you want to do an entire color. But since I'm going to leave this dark, all I'm going to do for this, and I do it to a lot of my secretaries, is leave the base of it wood, but then go in with black on the edges and everything. So I'm just getting it cleaned up, and then I will go in with black and add that in to make everything go together, but without having to paint inside every single little tiny cubby. Because that would ruin my life. So I'm going to work with very minimal colors here. I've got a really light pink and then kind of a fuchsia plum color, a blue and a yellow, and that's where I'm going with this. So when I do this over the top of the decoupage papers, I am using so little paint. It is paint and a lot of water because you still want to be able to see the image underneath. You're not trying to cover any of that up. So it is a very, very small amount of paint. This paint is very pigmented, so a little bit goes a long way. And I'm working out of the lid of the paint. That's it. There is not dipping the brush into the pot, none of that. It's just, I have the lid, I have a ton of water in there, and I will do it on the brush and then transfer it onto the paper. And you can add more paper to spread, you can add more water to spread it out. And that's kind of how I go about these. So what I'm doing here is I obviously did the yellow in the center. And then I'm taking the blue and I'm going into all the darker areas for the shading, because that would be the cooler shadows. And then I will go in with the fuchsia color and blend that into the blue up outwards. And then at the very end, I can hit some with the very, very light pink. And that's just to pop some areas. And that color doesn't go everywhere. So I'm just kind of fading out. I always start with the center and then I go with the darkest blue and then fade out into all the other colors. This is very easy to do, very, very forgiving. You can see if I get it on too strong in some areas, I just use my fingers and spread it out and help it blend. Again, it's very, very little paint. You're using such a small amount. And these, of course, could be any colors that you choose. I chose these because the vision in my head once I had these flowers on here and saw them with the black was I wanted them to be kind of deep and dark colors. So that's why I chose the blue and kind of the purpley color, and I wanted it to fade into that. And then I know that those are going to be the colors that I want to use on the actual piece itself. Once I get the flower all done, I'm going to do the same very, very light amount of paint. I'm misting over the entire black finish. I'm taking my large blending brush and I've just added a bit of the same colors that I used in the flower onto the piece, and I am swirling it all around over the black. So this will give you that stormy, kind of cloudy finish. It's just barely going over it and adding just lightness and texture. I don't know, it's so dreamy to see this in person when it's over the black, because you're adding so little paint, but it just adds that bit of highlight and it will help blend the black into the flower. So it's not such a stark contrast of having like the watercolor feel flowers with the stark black. You're now adding the swirling motions of watercolor throughout the black. Even though it's still really dark and still looks black, it just kind of helps everything meld together. And I'll kind of get my color placement where I want it. I'll do the deeper colors and the recesses and the lighter colors and the higher points of the serpentine part. And then I can go over the flowers. Again, I'm using such a small amount of paint and quite a bit of water, so that when I go over the flowers, you can still fully see them, but it helps blend them fully into the paint. Once I get the finish that I love, I'm going to seal with the same poly that I used earlier. Now the drop down desk portion here, I saved until last because again, I had something completely different in mind for the finish of this piece. And since it didn't turn out how I wanted to, I saved this because I wasn't sure how I wanted to tone out the wood. I ended up just watering down some walnut stain and using that because I didn't want to cover up all the red tones that were coming through. I actually liked them for this piece specifically because of the flowers that I had on here. And it looked really lovely. So I was fine with keeping that, but I wanted to even out the tones because as I sanded, I went a little further in some areas and others just because of all of the scuffs and scrapes and everything in it. Again, I tried to get it as smooth as possible. There's no way I could have gotten all of them out. There was just too many. But this worked lovely. It still kept all the original red tones, but since it was a watered down stain, I could kind of go over and just tone it out a little bit. So once that is on, gets wiped back, and then I'll just seal it again with the poly. So for that section of it, I sealed it with three different coats because those get so much use. I want to make sure that it's extra, extra, extra protected. And then of course, I will do my waxing. I felt the drawers were just too boring inside, so I used the same color that I did for the flowers and just stamped them. And like I said, this is the wax that I used in this case. I use a ton of the Chalk Mountain waxes. This is just the furniture restoring finish. I did it for these. These were sliding not the best, so I added wax to this, and then I did the wax all over the surfaces where they're going to get heavy use. If you've watched me for a while, you know that I do that. I poly and then I wax over anything that gets high traffic.
Oh, hi, Taryn here with Elegant Upgrades, and we've got our finished piece. This little thing turned out nothing like I had initially planned. Not even a little bit. It was going to be so light and very much like the little end table that I did. I'll put a little picture here so you can know what I'm talking about. That was where my mind was going with it. And this is what happened. And sometimes that happens to me, where it starts one way and then everything completely shifts gear and turns into something else entirely. I like it. It's very kind of dark, romantic type situation. I don't even know what you would call it. It's kind of, because we did the light, like watercolory things, it's a very dark watercolor feeling. I think it's lovely. So I can't use it for what I had originally planned on because, like I said, it was supposed to be lighter. So now this one's going up for sale, which is good. I need more pieces up for sale. I don't have enough already. But I don't know. And it's not super blingy. I initially was going to do gold leaf on the balls of the feet. And then I was like, oh, I kind of like how subdued everything is. So I just left it, and then of course the pulls gave me the hardest time ever. I'm so thankful that I had these ones in stock because, man, I got so mad at two different sets of pulls that just wouldn't work out for it. So thankfully I had these, and as soon as I put them on, I'm like, oh yes, those look awesome. And they're the perfect, like, dark but still has a little bit of kind of color to it to bring it out. So overall, yeah, I love this. I think it's gorgeous. I have no idea whose home this would fit into, but I hope somebody loves it. Hope you guys love this. Hope you learned something. Thank you so much for being here and watching and following along. I appreciate you guys so much. I'll get you some photos and I'll see you next week.